All right. Today we're going to take a look at the two different data-driven attribution models that are being used widely. Both are algorithmic models and both give a significant advantage over using a rule-based or a single touchpoint attribution model. Because with the data-driven model, you're able to move and expand into also marketing channels that are early in the customer journey. So you give much more, you get much more insight on what works in your marketing and what doesn't work. The first of the data-driven models that is being used widely is called Shapley value. It's sometimes also called the game theory model. And the Shapley value is being used by Google, for example. And what the Shapley value does is that it compares all the customer journeys and then it compares the incrementality on the different touch points. So let's say that we have one customer journey that is Facebook and then Google. And of course now it's on a channel level, but it could also be on a keyword level or content level or finer granularity. So in this case, we have a two touch point customer journey, and let's say that the conversion rate is 0.2. And then we have a second customer journey where you have Facebook, and then you have also Google as a second touch point. But then you also have a third touch point, which is, let's say that it's email. And then you have a conversion. And here in this case, the conversion rate would be 0.5. So, and now by comparing these, we could arrive at the conclusion that the value of the email touchpoint is 0.3, and that it lifts and the conversion rate that much. And that way you get the value of one touch point. And then when you do this on hundreds of thousands of customer journeys, you then are able to average them and average the impact of the different touch points. All right, and then the Markov model. What the Markov model does is that it also constructs all the customer journeys. And the Markov model in this case can be also called a little bit that it measures the removal effect. So we would have, for example, a network of customer journeys, and then you have Google, Facebook, and then let's say that we have email here, and then you have a network like this. So some start at Facebook, some start at Google, and then they continue, and some from Facebook come to Google, and then you have a conversion here, and then here you would have a churn. So that these would not convert. And then from the email you might have again, so that quite many, let's say that here you have 80% of these that get the email then convert. And here you maybe have just like 60%. And then when you have these probabilities in the whole network, the model then one by one simulates removal of one touch point and calculates how much would the total conversions change if this touch point would not exist. And that way you get the value of each and every touch point. And of course, now this is a very simplified example. In reality, it's much more complicated. Because these networks, when you have hundreds of thousands or millions of customer journeys, they become so complex, so it's impossible to visualize them. And what we are seeing is that the models usually give quite similar results. The most important thing is not to think so much about which model is being used, because they are quite similar in terms of results. However, it already gives so much value to have a data-driven model, have all the customer journeys, and then connect the values from the attribution model with the actual costs and that has been spent on these all these marketing channels, so you get a ROI, a data-driven ROI, for every touch point and every marketing channel, and that way then it becomes possible to measure the effect and the performance of all the different marketing efforts and then allocate the budgets in a much more efficient way.